Let's look at what makes a project. The first thing is that a project must have a purpose or goal. That is, there needs to be a reason that it is being done. Time-wise, all projects need to be contained. They must have a clear start point and a clear end point. If this does not exist, you're probably looking at a process rather than a project. Projects use resources. We're talking about time, money, people, materials, equipment, and machinery. These are all limited resources. When we conduct a project, we're trying to use those resources in an optimal way. Projects have an element of risk and uncertainty. All projects are unique in some way. Although projects can be similar, they will be unique in some way. If something meets these criteria, we need to start to apply some project management practices and approaches. This does not necessarily translate to producing copious amounts of documentation, but project management principles need to be applied and documented where appropriate. A neat definition comes out of the Project Management Body of Knowledge, or PMBOK, produced by the Project Management Institute, and that is, a project is a temporary endeavour undertaken to create a unique product, service, or result. Now let's take a look at the definition of project management. The best way to understand what we are doing in projects is first look at inputs. These are the project customer and stakeholder requirements and expectations. The role of the project manager is to convert these inputs into project deliverables, or outputs. Customers and stakeholders are more interested in the conversion of inputs to meet successful criteria or outcomes. It is in our interest, and those of our customers and stakeholders, to select and pursue projects that have the best possible chance of achieving outcomes, which will in turn produce value and benefits for the organisation and its clients. So while the project management might not be accountable for the outcome and benefits, they need to take an interest in those other aspects. This leads to the definition of project management that comes out of PMBOK. It is that project management is the application of knowledge, tools and techniques to project activities to meet project requirements. That knowledge comes from our reading, our studies, our experience. It can be both explicit and tacit knowledge. Let's look at the role of a project manager. This can be quite broad, but in essence it is there to achieve an objective. This is expressed in a scope statement. The role of the project manager is to deliver a scope within time, budget, and quality requirements. Project managers spend a lot of time managing risks, issues, and opportunities. A lot of time is spent on interfacing the work of the project with stakeholders and also many other projects that are competing for the same resources of time, money, people, equipment, and machinery. Project managers need an understanding of how to relate to and how to manage people and how to deal with people when they make mistakes. They need to understand organisational requirements because these can have a big impact on how we do our projects. Projects involve procurement in some way, either within the organisation or outside the organisation, so project managers need to understand how these practices work. Projects are about the transfer of information and having to communicate with people within the project as well as outside. Project managers need to be cognizant of safety requirements and practices. Project management requires the application of appropriate ethics and considerations for sustainability, not only of our organisations, but to achieve a balance between social, economic, and environmental factors.